We did a lot for the wins. Came in a drop on a 10. Now we on top, top once again. Yeah, yeah, yeah. I had to tighten the plan. Yeah, I got it right in the end. Now we on top, top once again. I don't want it if it ain't love. If it ain't get it away from me. Who you gonna jack if it ain't love?
EA Sports coverage of the National Football League is on the air. Coming up, it's divisional round Saturday, and we've got an AFC battle on tap between the Tennessee Titans and the Cleveland Browns. Outside the goal line. And able to get this across the 20, but not much further as he's dropped it to 23-yard line.
23-yard line.
First and 10, and kind of tipping their hand at running the ball. Three tight ends are out there. Carry for Derrick Henry. And this one goes nowhere. Losing yardage back at the 22. Officially, it's a one-yard loss. That's going to bring up second and 11.
Brings up second and 11 at the 22-yard line.
To start out here, second and 11. Throwing Jones. They set up the screen for Henry. They'll wind up getting 10 back as that sets him up for third down. They just play number three here on the opening drive, and it's an early third and one. They'll try to run for the first with Henry. And he's got Rome. And he gets this to the other side of midfield across the 45 before going out. Well, they were in search of a short gain on third down, and they wind up nabbing over 20 yards. So a first and 10 upcoming from Browns territory now at the 44-yard line. The gun. Jones. That's complete to his running back, Evans. And he goes down, but not before getting this inside the 25. Chewing up big yardage. Another nice gain there. This one goes for 20.
Tennessee.
A first down carry for Henry. And he'll be taken down near the 20 at the 21. 3 yards on the pickup there, and it'll be second down.
Well, I think that's what they're going to need to do here in the first half. You've got to take some pressure off of this young quarterback, and no better way to do it than to establish the running game early.
On second and 7, Jones. Smith catches left side and stopped a few yards shy of the goal line at the 3. His first reception of the divisional round matchup, but it's good for a first down as well. And he will take this one in for a Titans touchdown. From 3 yards out, and the Titans take the ball down the field and score on their opening drive. Well, these guys have won 3 straight ball games and another good start to this one out to the 6-0 lead.
And I've talked with so many different coaches, as have you, along the way, and they always talk about winning streaks and the mood of a team and how much easier it is to actually prepare during that time. Guys are sharp, guys are focused, everyone's feeling good, and we're seeing it early in this one.
Out is the kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away. A short kick taken at the 18. A lane opens here. He's past the 30.
First down 10 at their own 34-yard line.
Up now, first and 10 at the 34. And now with the play clock getting down, Kevin Stefanski going to take a timeout. They'll have two remaining as we step aside here in this first quarter. From the 34 now, here's first and 10. And he'll get two, maybe three, up near the 37.
They'd love to just strike back with a touchdown right here, and if it's a long play, so be it. But the main goal, get a couple of first downs, run some plays, run some clock, allow their defense to get a chance to catch their breath, settle down, and relax a little bit after they just gave up a score.
The last run got three. Now here's second and 7.
Keep two eyes on the football when you know the contact's coming, let alone getting two hands around it, hugging it to your body, and absorbing the hit, even for those big tight ends who you would think could absorb that contact.
On third down, Mayfield.
Frustration there, back-to-back incompletions, receivers blanketed on both attempts, this time on third down.
On fourth down, here's Jamie Gillen on to punt. Back deep, Adoree Jackson. And he'll get this away into the icy winter air. Too cute there on the punt return. Sometimes they forget paramount holding on to that football.
I really do believe most of the return guys think to themselves, when I get the ball, I'm going to make the play that's going to change the game.
I'm going to break it.
And you love that they have that attitude, but your point is so well taken. What do you have to do? First and foremost,
hold on to it.
Take care of the football. That's all he needed to do.
First carry now for Nick Chubb. And a nice job to break free of one tackle, but it slowed his momentum somewhat, and he's taken down right after.
Well, it's time for them to be good teammates right here, and what I mean by that is possess the ball for a little while. Get at least two first downs. Give their defense a chance to settle down a little bit after they give up a touchdown.
Chubb on second down. He is taken down at the 21 after a short gain of two. 2 yards on the first down carry and then followed up by 2 yards on the second down carry.
Well, that's definitely not going to be enough to get the job done. Wasn't the expression 3 yards in a cloud of dust?
Now they're going to need six on third down to keep the drive going. Of this great starting field position they had. Here's third and six. From the shotgun, it's Mayfield. And he will find his man on the outside. And he'll be stopped short of the first down, right around the 18-yard line. They get only four that time as that leads us to a fourth down.
It's fourth down.
And Kevin Stefanski going to take a chance, going for it on fourth. Field to throw for it on fourth. It's going to be caught at the 10-yard line. And the Browns are going to have first and goal as they try to finish off this drive with 6 points. On to the second from Cleveland. It's the Browns in control of the football as they go to work on a first and goal. Working out of the gun, Mayfield to the end zone, but it's incomplete. The Pro Bowler Odell Beckham, the intended receiver, but it'll be second and goal.
I think he's got to be careful not to force anything into coverage right there. There weren't really any throwing lanes, but the best part for him, he's got second and third down to fall back on.
Nothing on first down, so the ball remains at the 8-yard line, second and goal. Mayfield hands to Chubb on the draw. And he's able to break out of one tackle, but then quickly brought down. Only a yard there, and that'll bring us to third and goal.
Partner, I know we're in a goal-to-go situation, but my goodness, think about running the ball here. Not even a thought, is it?
Yeah, defensively, they're in a prime spot.
And I think the defensive guys are probably expressing themselves to them as well. I wouldn't run it here, guys. You might want to try throwing it.
Ball rests on the 7-yard line, third and goal. And he'll take this one down inside the 5 to the 3. It's about a 3-yard pickup there, but more importantly, they're still a few yards away here. It's now fourth down and goal.
On for the field goal. A 20-yard attempt.
The kick by Pinheiro is good. And they are on the board, but still trailing. It's 7-3. A good drive gets them inside the 5, but they could not punch it in.
And credit the defense, too. Make sure that that happens, because that was the old bend but don't break approach. Made sure they contained them when they absolutely had to and forced the field goal attempt that went through.
This will be fielded inside the 5. And he's going to get this across the 20 as he's out of bounds at the 23.
At their own 23-yard line.
The Titans offense set to begin the drive. And for them, a touchdown their last go around. Obviously, they'll be hoping to do that again.
And when you start plotting for this drive, when you start thinking to yourself, okay, what are we going to do? You don't go away from what you did before because that worked. But you have to be prepared for wrinkles and counters because you know they'll make some adjustments.
It's a 6-yard pickup, but it gets them to second and four.
Well, I think after that run, the defense is getting back in the huddle and looking at each other and maybe starting to question their confidence a bit. They gave up a significant run, 6 yards, and now you're saying to yourself, how do we stop them, and do I have enough confidence to make a play?
On second down, here's Henry. And he'll get it up near the 35, right at the 34 here.
So many teams want to throw the ball in this situation nowadays, but I love watching a team that has enough confidence to go ahead and run the football in that situation. That's almost a tendency breaker.
From the 34 now, here's first and 10. Off play action, Jones. Gets to him that time, and he's going to go down. Sione Takitaki in there to get him. It's a loss of 5.
It's second down.
Coming up now on a 2nd and 15 following that sack. Another try after the first down sack. Jones, lots of screen pass. That's complete. And he will lose yardage here back at the 23-yard line. Now that screen there on second down certainly didn't develop how they had hoped. Is that one they should have even tried, or is that one the quarterback sticks in his pocket?
I think the latter. I like what you said there, because trying is one thing. We can second guess just about every call. But in this case, when you realize it is broken down, just throw it at the feet of your intended receiver so that no one can pick it off, right? You don't have the ball tipped up in the air, and you come back and try and pick up the first down on third down. That way you don't lose any yardage.
Need something from deep in the bag of tricks here after first and second down went backwards. It's third and very long. Operating from the gun, Jones. And he takes this one back into the end zone. The Browns defense has a touchdown. And we'll see if that pick six looms large as this game continues, because we've seen plays like that alter a lot of playoff contests over the years.
I would agree with that totally. You often think to yourself, why do they alter it so much? Because after games, don't we hear coaches and players say, well, one play doesn't usually determine the outcome. But I don't think that's really true, do you? Because there's times when we see plays like that, and all of a sudden the momentum jumps to that team side, it deflates the other side, and they never pick it back up. And then things really go from there, don't they?
That's the thing for me. We talk about momentum changes. A play like that is the ultimate momentum change. And he'll go down as this drive will start at the 25-yard line. 25-yard line. Offense set to begin the drive. Jones throwing after the interception. Man over the left side is Brown. It'll be a pickup of 10 yards. And that'll bring up a 2nd and just about a few inches here.
Brandon, perfect defense in this situation would have meant that there was an incompletion that would have picked it off. Okay, so they gave up the completion. But I really enjoyed watching how the defense stayed in sync, stayed in great communication. And as he dragged across each zone, you see him pointing, communicating. There he is, and they passed him off to each defender. Ended up making a nice play, even though it was complete.
And he's going to get forward for about five, but that may be coming back. What say you, Mr. Referee? It's Henry. A pickup of about 3 yards as he's taken down at the 31. 1:58 left to play till we hit halftime. We remind you, as we've done all year, that coming up at halftime, we will visit with Jonathan Coachman, standing by in Orlando. He'll let you know what's going on here on a very eventful divisional round weekend. On third down, Henry. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. Third and medium, they opted to run instead of pass, and it worked. First down.
Obviously an important run to avoid the three and out on your own side of the field.
Shows a lot of faith in that offensive unit, doesn't it? That you want to run the ball in that situation. Pick up the first down. Also helps out your defensive guys a little bit, too. Allows them to get at least one more series of downs in order to get some rest.
Throw on first down there, but it's incomplete. Defensively, Charles, they continue to really limit this offense as far as yardage goes.
Yeah, you're exactly right. They've been assignment sound, staying in their lanes, keeping proper leverage, and communicating well, too.
Now Jones, gonna throw again. And oh, this is taken in one hand, and what a catch. He'll go down, but not before getting this inside the 30. That'll go as a pickup of 32 on the catch and run. So now then, the big play has him all the way inside the 30 now, first and 10. Firing quickly here, and that's complete. 5 yards on the catch there, brings up second down. The Titans going to use the first of their timeouts as they get the stoppage with a little over 50 seconds to go in the first half. 5 yards remain on second down. Now Jones. And on the left sideline, he caught it, but out of bounds, according to the head linesman. Incomplete. So the ball a little late getting there, and it's third down. That pass just a little bit off. It looked like maybe he tried to force it in there.
Game speed, always different, no matter what you do in practice. Can't simulate it, right? So your decision-making, everything has to be a little bit quicker. Sometimes it can throw you off until you adjust.
Again, he'll drop the throw. And a double coverage, and it's intercepted. Picked up by Denzel Ward.
He's had a fantastic rookie season, made a lot of lovely throws, but that wasn't one of them.
Well, we got to give him one, don't we? I mean, with the year he's having, a lot easier for he and his teammates to accept that throw, because for the most part, what they've seen, it's been pretty sensational.
The Browns drive about to get started, and we'll see how this is played. Offensively, they've got the lead, not a whole lot of time left. What do you think, Charles?
Well, it's tempting to try and add to your lead. A mistake there. Have to change things in a big way. I said go ahead and take the knee. Get on out for the half.
Now the Browns signal for the second of their timeouts. As the clock will stop with 35 seconds to go in quarter number two. So first and 10 now from the 30. From the shotgun now. Here's an inside give. And defensively, they're just looking to keep him contained as they're able to get him down. Rashad Evans out of Alabama had the tackle defensively.
That's a really good gain right there. They pick up 5 yards halfway to a first down.
And it's intercepted. Picked by Kevin Byer. And these guys have got it back at the closing stages of the first half.
At their own 42-yard line.
The Titans offense set to begin the drive. And with time quickly fading here in the second quarter, not sure how aggressively, offensively they want to play this.
I think we'll find out just how much they trust their guys in this situation if they decide to take a shot.
He's going to fire one deep left. This is caught at the 20. And down to the 20 he'll go before heading out of bounds.
A gain of 39 that time.
On the play. First down, Tennessee.
So even though it's first down, here's the field goal unit on now to try to get three before halftime. From the left hash, this from 37. And the 38-year-old vet able to split the uprights. So a late turnover leads to a quick drive, and in turn that quick drive leads to 3 points.
So someone makes a mistake, but how about the other side learning from that mistake, taking care of the ball, and making sure they put some points on the board? Well done.
As the kick's away. They're going to mark that where it went out of bounds. So really good starting field position up past the 40-yard line. For the Browns, good starting field position as they have it first and 10 at the 41-yard line. Divisional round matchup. As we'll send you down to Orlando, we check in with Jonathan Coachman for our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach, win or go home, that's the name of the game, and we're back underway with the second half of this AFC Divisional round.
Fielded a couple yards into the end zone.
And ultimately cannot get this out to the 25-yard line as he's dropped at the 23.
Their own 23-yard line.
Cleveland offense ready to go. We have not seen much on offense from either side these last few drives. It has been a struggle, hasn't it?
Totally, and you're thinking to yourself right now, if you're on offense trying to get things figured out, okay, we self-scout every week on our game plan. How many things do we do at certain times? What are our tendencies? Time to go to some of those tendency breakers and try and create some offense.
They always have those in their back pocket, don't they?
You have to, and if you don't keep abreast of what you're doing, you lock into a rhythm and make it easy for the opposition.
Looking for tendency breakers right now. Again, it's Chubb. And some room to run now. And all the way inside the 35 before he goes out of bounds. A big play that time out of Chubb. 41 yards on the ground.
3-yard line.
So the big play changes the complexion of things. Here's first and 10 just outside the 30. Now a handoff here to his running back. Works his way inside the 30 on a pickup of 4.
Number 28.
Well, the end of all that hitting and hollering, it was a 4-yard run, so the offense is going to go back down and feel pretty good about themselves. Defensively, you have to feel okay because you didn't let it turn into a bigger run, but the goal, shut it down for 2 yards or less. That's when you start to feel good about yourselves.
Here's a carry for the fullback. This is Andy Janovich. 2 yards the gain there, and now they're left with a third and about 4 for a first.
7-yard line. A gain of 2 on the play. Brings up 3rd and 4.
Regular, regular, regular. Mayfield to throw it. Fourth down now as the Titans defense holds up in coverage.
Oh, that's got to frustrate him a little bit because it nearly got to him there, and it would have been the first sack of the game instead. They're able to influence the release, and they did force the incomplete pass.
So out comes the field goal team now for the second time here today. He hit his first one, this from 44 yards out now. This is up and good from Pinheiro. And the Browns are out to a 3-0 lead. They don't get a touchdown here on the opening drive of the third quarter, but I think maybe you still say mission accomplished as they come away with the lead.
No, absolutely. You keep the pressure on, right? You go downfield, get some points up on the board, and hope that you motivated your defense to take the field and hold that lead.
Get it up past the 20 to about the 22.
At their own 22-yard line.
The Titans' offense set to begin the drive. They trail offense, first time to touch the ball in quarter three, and we'll see what they can do.
And I can't wait to see what they have planned, because some teams script to start a half. Other teams just go, okay, these are the sequence of plays we want to run. These things worked well for us. And sometimes they throw in that big chunk play right away.
Shocker.
Try and get after them early and try and create a big play to give themselves some momentum.
See what they have up their sleeve. The last run got six. Now second and four. The 40. Maybe out of bounds, but able to get it up past the 45. That one good for a first down pickup of 18 yards. Just a simple tap pass, but it pays off in a big way.
And sometimes the simple stuff causes the most problems for a defense because there's a breakdown in communication there. When that receiver goes behind the line of scrimmage and it looks like he's going in motion, someone either has to go with him or he has to be passed off to another defender. Somehow, they didn't get that communicated well, and it turned into a nice play.
Brings up second and two.
8 yards the tally on that first down run. Here's second and two. Again, it's Henry. And this time he's able to take it down to the 42. 4 yards the pickup, first down.
Second and two is prime time for a little bit of a gamble, isn't it? Open up the playbook, go play action, toss that bad boy deep. But in this situation, go ahead and give it to your back. Let him pick up a first down. Keep the sticks moving.
On first down. Yardage back at the 43-yard line. They'll lose a yard there, and it's second and 11.
With his size, he's a tough man to bring down, but they do a nice job there stopping his progress and not allowing him to get back to the line of scrimmage.
Second and 11 now. Jones. That's complete to Darrington Evans, the running back. And here he'll be brought down a little shy of the 35 at the 36. Looked like a pretty good safe play right there. No, he's had trouble with the interceptions in this game there. Hits his guy out in the flat.
Yeah, so many times we hear quarterbacks and offensive coordinators talk about in your progressions, you're either throwing the touchdown or you're throwing the check down. But earlier in the game, it was touchdown or interception. Now he got to the check down. A nice safe throw and a good one.
Browns D locked in on third down. Brings up fourth.
Incomplete. It's fourth down.
Off the field, they're going on fourth and five.
from the gun. Jones. And a quick throw here that's complete. And he gets it down a yard or two shy of the 30 before he's out of bounds.
Well, we kind of looked at each other as they decided to go for it. But in the end, great execution, a six-yard gain, and it all works out.
Line of scrimmage, the 31 now on first and 10.
One quarter remains for the right to advance to the AFC title game. We'll return with more after this. This is the NFL, and it's on EA Sports.
Henry, and he will lose yardage back to the 34-yard line. That's going to wind up a loss of a full 3 yards on first down. That loss of three, a rare stumble on a promising drive. Here's second and 13. Now we've got movement up front. I think this is going to be on the Titans. The crowd's not doing that O-line any favors.
Home field advantage is really kicking in, making it very difficult for them to hear the snap count.
And that false start penalty is certainly not helping their cause here. Second down and long. They'll run it again with Henry. If they didn't have that penalty a moment ago, it'd be a first down. Still a nice 13-yard pickup.
It's a gain of 13, but it brings up third down.
Off the play fake. Jones. And he'll find Galladay. That's complete. And into the end zone for a Tennessee touchdown.
Touchdown.
25 yards for the touchdown. And the Titans are going to retake the lead. Those are the touchdowns that aren't just scored on Sundays or on Monday night. Those are the ones that are scored during the week because they had that preparation in a great route run.
Oh, I love that observation because you don't just roll out on game day and say, okay, go run this route and let's get it done. That means exactly what you said. The practice had to occur beforehand, which led to the timing, which led to the touchdown.
Set now to kick this one away, and off it goes. Fielded a couple yards into the end zone. And it'll come out to the 25 as he will not attempt to return.
5-yard line.
The Browns drive about to get started. And this could be the defining moment of their season, all hyperbole aside. You're trailing here in the fourth quarter, the divisional round. They need to come up with something as they get this drive started. And he's going to be dropped following a pickup of 7, past the 30 to the 32.
Well, partner, I know this type of running back. I mean, this size, this intensity usually gets better as the game goes on. I just tell you from experience, the first few quarters, oh, you're eager. You come running up there, I'm going to tackle this guy. By the fourth quarter, you're coming up and thinking about it.
And D-line wearing down fourth quarter. Yeah, that's not a guy they want to see consistently. It's a first down on a gain of 10.
42-yard line.
Time to the tailback. And some space here. And they're going to have this all the way down deep into Tennessee territory. A big play that time for Cleveland. 45 yards on the ground. Running game working. They'll stick with it on first down. Stopped a few yards shy of the goal line at the 3. 10 more there and another first down.
First down. First and goal at the 3-yard line.
They'll try to run this one in. They're able to get a couple here, but won't get across the plane as they stop it right around the one.
This drive is pretty clear. Almost feels like old school fundamentals, doesn't it? Want to impose their will on the defense. What's that, five straight runs?
Yeah, five straight carries to start this drive. And like you said, the way it's working, they may just stick with it. Second and goal from the one.
Get his first touchdown here in the playoffs. Perhaps the week off energized him.
A great article in the paper this morning basically saying that they would not have won the division without him, and he's not their only piece, but I think that's a fair statement.
It's easy to say it this way. He's their main cog.
The kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away. Dropped at the 21-yard line, so bringing it out of the end zone proves not a good decision. Loses him about 4 yards. Offense set to begin the drive, and this certainly a key moment in this game, trailing by three, fourth quarter, with a spot in the championship game next weekend on the line. Oh, he's got a little daylight, and they're able to get this one across the 35. That's a good way to start the drive, 17 yards and a first down.
It's a gain of 17 yards. First down, Titans.
So the Titans in possession of the football here as we get you reset. And let's see what they've come up with offensively after having time to talk it over. A first down run, good for about three. Second and seven coming up.
Yeah, I don't know if it's exactly a win-win, but if you're on offense, you'll take that kind of a run, all right? It was kind of stacked up, found a little bit of yardage, and frankly, they're pretty close to staying on schedule on offense. The playbook is still open for the coordinator.
To throw. Throw inside complete. It's Smith. Yeah, he's going to be out of bounds, but not before he takes it inside the 40. A gain there of 21 yards.
First down.
So here's a first and 10 at the 38. Henry will get it. He's been busy today. And he's going to be taken down with a marker on the field. So let's see about the call. So a decent gain, but all for naught on the penalty.
It's too bad, isn't it? They were feeling pretty good about it. The only people celebrating, the guys who just gave up that play.
So following the hold, they're in a bit of a hole here with a first and 20. He's back to throw. Looking left side, and he's got a man. That's Smith. It's a big play, yet amazingly, because of how far they had to go, they're still looking at a second down here.
Second down at the 31-yard line.
Henry. First down and much more for Henry.
Touchdown, Titans!
Derrick Henry.
31 yards. And the Titans have taken the lead here in the fourth quarter.
He has been an integral part of the offense all season, and now in the playoffs he's carrying it over. Had the touchdown last week in the wild card game. Now his second TD of the playoffs.
Showing some consistency, and that's something that we have to keep in mind about the playoffs, because we often think you have to be spectacular in order to win. I think consistent is what you're looking for. That can get you to the finish line.
Fielded a couple yards into the end zone. And tackled at the 21-yard line, so a net negative there of 4 yards.
Cleveland offense ready to go. They're down here in a one-score game. At the time, it's a factor, but it's not a huge factor right now, is it?
It's really not, because this amount of time gives them a chance to run their offense, to go through play sequences. And this is what they work on every week in practice, usually on a Friday. They go over this type of a situation, late game situation. What are we going to do when we have the opportunity? They've called these plays a bunch of times. Now's their chance to execute them.
Yeah, they have the opportunity now. Here's the execution. Now Mayfield.
We've seen that the deep ball has been a part of their game plan all afternoon, but they've had trouble hooking up on it, unable to successfully find the end zone over the top.
Back to throw. They get it right at the 32nd mark of this fourth quarter.
Stimjan at the 40-yard line.
Mayfield. Third and final timeout as the clock stops with 23 seconds to go in the game. Mayfield to throw. Eluding the pressure run. And it is incomplete. 17 seconds now on the clock here.
They've given up a few first downs on this drive, but getting the incompletion there, that should give them something to build on and maybe turn the tide.
An incomplete pass on first down. That leads to a second and 10. Here's Mayfield. And that's going to be incomplete. 12 seconds left.
Over to the sideline and incomplete. Brings up third down and 10.
So back-to-back incompletions, and that has him staring at a third and 10.
throw. Flush to his right. And, oh, a crusher there as it's intercepted. Picked up by Amari Hooker. The Titans are moving on. As we say, so long, everybody.
20.
Just about do it for Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gordon. You've been watching the NFL on EA Sports. For more, log on to EASports.com. With that, we say so long, everybody.